All right, we're ready to rock and roll here in just a second. And Scotty Townsend is hitting a few balls here on the TV table right now. Charles Hunter once again joining me in the booth. Charles, this should be a good one here. What do you think?
This should be a really good matchup.
Catching it. Again, Scotty Townsend's warming up to the table. Jerry Slivka is here. I believe he's about ready as well, but I don't see him just yet. Scotty Townsend. Haven't seen Scotty out in some time playing. It's good to see him out. Last tournament I covered that Scotty was at was down in Thibodaux, Louisiana, a bar box tournament down there. And Scotty came in and was ready to play. And he just couldn't do it. He'd gotten bit by a spider.
Wow.
And on his elbow, and it was on his bridge arm, and it was just too painful. It's just swollen up to the joint in his elbow.
I saw him play at Action Billiards in West Monroe not long ago.
Oh yeah. Yes. Yeah, we're actually going to be in West Monroe coming up at Action Billiards in the first weekend in October.
I was told that was going to be the last weekend of October.
Well, I'll have to check my schedule again.
That's what I was told yesterday. Because O'Banion's in West Monroe is the first weekend.
Yeah, if they change that, I haven't heard anything yet. But I'll take a look at my schedule right now. Second weekend in October.
Okay.
I guess O'Banion's might be the first weekend.
Must
that would be.
Be
the second weekend.
I got some bad information last night. So.
And then White Diamond is the first weekend in November.
That's always a great tournament. Try to make that whenever possible.
Seven. All the way through. Final two. Final two. Double amazing.
Scotty Townsend over there asking about the race. Race to seven. Both sides off the late break. All the way through, even in the finals.
All right, Jerry Slivka is back.
Not ready to get started.
We've got a air conditioner vent that's blowing right towards us here. I mean, it's nice and cool over here.
It is.
But we do get an occasional gust of wind there.
It's going to be a really interesting match here. You got a player that likes to play fast and get out, and then you got Scotty that likes to grind. Haven't seen Jerry out playing anywhere lately either.
Yeah, Jerry's just had a baby 6 months ago.
Really?
He is now brother-in-law to Sam Gilmer.
That's right. He's going to knock a few around and try to get warmed up, and we'll get this match underway. I got Okay, ready to get this match underway.
Here we go. Barry Slivka, originally out of Philadelphia, I think, or Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh,
yeah, and living down in Starkville now.
Now they're discussing who's going to rack, who's going
to... I think Jerry might have suggested rack your own.
Play rack your own.
Scotty said, hey, let's just play the tournament rules.
Right.
For each other and just put them up there and let's break them.
That's the way it ought to be. Everybody played the same way. Okay, Scotty Townsend with the break.
We're gonna have to donate a towel to Scotty there.
Little too much skin for the TV camera.
Man, I tell you what, he's in good shape. I definitely wouldn't want to be doing that.
I'm with you, Ray.
That's it, I'm going to the gym. All right, I'm doing leg lifts right here in the booth now.
Ray's going to be shape and in shape and fit by the time this match is over.
You know, I need to get one of those like those little mini stair stepper things that you can stand on while you're commentating. You know, I could get some exercise.
Get some exercise in.
Yeah, it's brutal. You know, just sitting all the time.
That might be the way I get my exercise, is just walking around the table.
Right. Yeah, same here. Unfortunately, that's all I get is turning corners, and I didn't do enough of that.
Turning corners and grabbing the rack.
Grabbing the rack. Must be playing rack your own. Scotty Townsend.
All right, Scotty with the opening break, ready to go.
Man, he parked him right in the middle of the table. Nice break.
Gotta watch Scotty, because just when you think he doesn't have a shot, he pulls out a rabbit.
Come up with one, yeah. Yeah, I remember the tournament down in Thibodaux that he was at.
Oh, bro.
Wow. He played a long rail cross bank on the bar box and nailed it and got out. It was amazing. Good stuff. Slivka getting his equipment out and ready, and here we go. Strike number one. They got that music rocking today, don't they?
Yeah, it's a little loud.
That sounds a lot better. Well, I tell you what, there's not a whole lot of room for mistakes here on these bar boxes.
No, not with some of these champions. If you miss, you concede the game, and you know, maybe the next one too.
Yep. Benny Conway Jr. playing in the top of your screen there, caddy corner table. Little D in the background with his purple hustling shirt on.
That's a really good matchup going on back there. Little D's playing Herman Quarles from Brookhaven.
Herman plays good.
Really good player.
Solid.
That's a good matchup back there. Not sure what the score is.
I remember the last time I played Herman Quarles, and it wasn't pretty for me.
Herman has a nice 9-foot diamond at his house that he plays on quite regularly, so it makes playing on this bar box really easy for him.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I had one for several years. I ended up had a pro-am 9-foot. Ended up selling it and buying some cameras. Here I am.
Here I am.
I do miss it, though. You're playing, aren't you, Charles?
Yes, I played earlier. I played Alex Olinger from Kentucky.
Oh, yeah? How'd you come out?
I lost 7-3.
Wow. Alex, good player.
He's a real good player. I gave him the 2-1 his way. I missed the 8 and a scratch on the 9. So instead of it being 3-2 my way, it's 4-1 his way, and I never catch up from that. I think they had me here for my Calcutta skills and not my pool playing, though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're all right. I mean, you're no Chris Miller, but, you know, you're all right.
Yeah, well, how many Chris Millers are there?
Just
one.
Yep,
just thank one. Goodness. Yeah. That guy's a nut. If I could get my Calcuttas running like that, it'd be something. He's great.
Yeah, it'll be a sad day when there's no more Chris Miller. That's
for
sure.
Man, that guy's, he is something else. I've been to a lot of tournaments in the last 10 years playing pool, and I've never been to anything that's close to what goes on at his place.
Yeah, really a nice show.
It is.
And speaking of nice show,
there it is.
Looks like Jerry Slivka is going to take rack number one here.
Wins rack one and gets the break.
Yep. Yeah, I guess Scotty, a little careless on that shot he took, and hung it up.
Yeah, that 1-bar, 1-7 combo hung in the corner, and it cost him. He would have been out more than likely.
Somebody partying down over there.
Yeah, that's the local. He spent a lot of money in the Calcutta. I guess we'll give him a little break. He threw a lot of money our way. So.
He gets a little extra leeway.
Yeah, he gets a little leeway. They'll quiet him down over there before he gets too loud.
Yeah, he is having a large time over there.
He definitely is. We apologize for any foul language it might come across, because he'll let one loose back there in a minute, I promise you.
That's hilarious. He's probably going to have a hangover tomorrow.
Nah, this is an everyday event right here. It doesn't have to be anything special going on for Ray to be up here acting crazy.
Oh, his name's Ray?
It is.
Oh, hey, I apologize for all Rays, all you Rays out there. Nah, he's having a good time.
Wow.
Nobody home. Or did he make a ball?
No, dry break.
They're all there, you're right. Scotty Townsend coming to the table with shot at the 1-ball, but I don't really see a pocket for it. Maybe in the side pocket, but it's a tough one.
Maybe he shoots it to the end rail and plays safe behind the 2 balls over on the side rail.
Yeah, that could work. He could also shoot it into the 8-5 and draw in behind the 9, probably about a 3 over there too, and kind of maybe break that problem up over there. But let's see what Scotty Townsend comes up with here. Well, it looks like I'm going to be up in another match here, and I'm slipping away here. Charles, you going to stick around?
I can.
Okay. Well, all you do is just someone.
Click on.
Oh, I got to play Gary. Just click plus one whenever somebody scores one. You're all good.
All right. I'll try to keep it under wraps for you.
All right.
Good luck in your match.
Thanks a lot. I'll be back in just a second.
All right. Good shot by Jerry. Thought Scotty had him hooked behind that ball, but I guess not. Ray has gone off to play his match. I'm going to try to keep you all informed on this one right here. Scotty left him a wide open shot. Well, maybe not. Two ball is hit behind the seven down there. Taking a while here to try to figure out how he wants to hit this two ball. Jerry didn't stick him behind the three, but he got him down there way down table behind that seven. There for a second. Left him out. I didn't leave him too much. We'll see what Jerry can come up with here. Safe on the five. I think the ball came out where Scotty can see it. Let's see Benny Conway at the tournament board over there. Just won another match. Jerry Slivka trying to kick, line up the one row kick. Gets a roll. Spoke with Daryl Biggert. Someone earlier was asking about how the one pocket matchup came with here and Robert Frost yesterday. Darrell said he lost a couple games. Probably going to play again here in a little while. Long game taking place right here. Safe on the tee a couple times. Everybody can get started to make a ball and run out. Missed the name of a while ago, but a viewer was asking about what kind of cue Slivka was playing with. He says it's a Sean, a 30-year-old Sean. Good-looking cue. Okay, finally someone gets an open shot on this match. Shot right there by Scotty, made a great hit, got a good lead. Long drawn out game right here. Shot by Jerry. Gets in behind the five, kicks it, makes a nine in the corner. So now the score is 2-0 Jerry's way. Two nothing, swiftest way, Scotty Townsend breaking in the third game. Fly on the one. Thank you. little bit of a bad roll there for Jerry. Trying to push the five up so it goes. I'm not sure what he can do right here. He's looking at the billiard off the five and make the seven. Nice shot. Misses that eight up along the rail, gives Scotty a chance. Would have been up 3-0. Could make it 2-1. Big change. Wow, not sure about that. We won't see a veteran. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let me see if I can find out. Looks like next up on the TV table is going to be maybe Daryl Biggert and Nick Hickerson, or possibly Little D playing Gary Abu. Not really sure yet. Find out here in a moment. This match still going on right now. Not over completely. Even though Slivka's in control. On the hill with the break. Oh, he scratches on the break. Still a chance for Scotty. Stay in this. Scotty with ball in hand. Let's see what he can come up with right here. Scotty might have this rack under control. Possibly make this match 6-4. Not over with yet. Scotty does run out, makes the score 6-4 with Scotty in the break. Break a run right here, right back in the match. Scotty strolls over, does a little equipment work. Calm as ever, ready to come back to the table. Time getting those balls to freeze up there on the table. These guys want the rack just right, and we're all touching. All right, looks like we're ready to go here in rack 11. 6-4 Jerry Slivka's way. Scotty makes a couple of balls in the break with scratches. Wide open table. This match will probably be over. Pretty easy run out for Slivka. No problem with tie-up balls. Matter of staying with him and making them all. Shaking his head like he's a little disappointed with the positioning on that ball, but I believe he's going to be fine. To go, seven ball straight up, nine ball in the side. This match will be over. Like Jerry Slivka is going to win 7-4 over Scotty Townsend. Indeed, it is Jerry Slivka winning 7-4. That's the conclusion of this match. Not sure yet who's going to be up on the TV table just yet. Going to take a little small break. As soon as we can find out who's going to be up next, we will let you know.